You know, this, as I indicated, the Senate caucus rejected this tentative agreement because of that issue, that they demanded that the wages had to be slashed. In fact, I had indicated to Senator Corker that if we were going to use Toyota as a benchmark, then our research department was prepared to go to Toyota, not with a leap of faith, but dealing with the facts, go in and review their entire wage structure. In addition to that, if we were going to use them as a benchmark, we should be permitted to see how they paid their management. If we did that, we should also see their dealer contracts as well as their supplier contracts. That only would make sense to me, instead of somebody saying, here's the wage, and that's what you have to agree to. However, they did add a couple of other companies then that they wanted to use as a benchmark. The demand by the Senate GOP caucus would have, no question, treated workers differently from every other stakeholder, instead of leaving it to the auto czar to work out the timetable and the mechanism for implementing sacrifices by all of the stakeholders. And the GOP caucus tried to mandate the precise restructuring terms for workers. In effect, that means that the GOP caucus was insisting that the restructuring had to be done on the backs of workers and retirees rather than having all stakeholders come to the table. And from the beginning, the UAW has recognized, made it clear, and so testified in front of the Congress of the United States that all stakeholders had to be willing to make sacrifice. Even though we have stepped forward on three major occasions, and as I've said many times, we're on third base and the other stakeholders are not even in the ballpark. We've already stepped forward and made enormous concessions, but as we made it clear last night, we were prepared to make further sacrifices. But we could not accept the effort by the Senate GOP caucus to single out workers and retirees for different treatment and to make them shoulder the entire burden of any restructuring. And now that the Senate GOP caucus has repudiated the positions taken by President Bush and by Senator Corker and scuttled the legislation to provide the emergency bridge loans to the automakers, the only options are for Treasury Secretary Paulson to exercise his authority to use the TARP funds to provide assistance, or for the Federal Reserve to take action. And the UAW calls on Secretary Treasurer Paulson or the Federal Reserve to use their authority to prevent the imminent collapse of the automakers and the devastating consequences that would follow for millions of workers, retirees, for families across our nation, and for our economy as a whole. So with that, I very much appreciate the media being here this morning. We appreciate the reporting that you have done on these issues, because from where we're standing, I can see how no one could level criticism at the men and women of the UAW. Now, I recognize that there are some out there who would do that. But if you sit down and look at the facts, and I have stated the facts here this morning to you as I believe them to be. If you look at the facts, the men and women of the UAW care about our country. And by the way, we will continue as a union to put full energy into bringing a successful resolve to this situation.